So what's good, y'all? We back in here with another video. And as we all know, the Philadelphia 76ers have had some super high expectations for the past 3-4 years now, and just really could not get anything going, have had some really unfortunate luck, and they just can't get over the hump, as they are yet to make an Eastern Conference Finals appearance since the year 2001, when Allen Iverson had carried the Sixers all the way to the NBA Finals and lost to the Los Angeles Lakers. But that was all supposed to change this past season, because when the 76ers traded for Hall of Famer, you could say, future Hall of Fame guard James Harden, it was to form one of the NBA's best big threes in Joel Embiid, James Harden, and Tyrese Maxey. And it started off well, as James Harden's first 4 games with the Sixers were all wins, and he was putting up vintage James Harden numbers. He averaged 26.8 points per game, 12 assists a night, 7.5 rebounds a night as well, and shot super efficient through those first 4 games, shooting 59% from the field and 50% from three. But as the season went on, James Harden kind of went back to being the way he had been for the whole season prior, and that was bad. Because after those first 4 games with Philly, James Harden averaged 17 points per game on 36% shooting and 29% from beyond the arc. And this play didn't just stop there, because in the playoffs, it was just as bad. He only scored 20 plus points 3 times in the 2022 playoffs and scored over 30 once. Mind you, James Harden was brought in to push the Sixers over the edge and become the reliable scoring option that Embiid had been waiting for ever since Ben Simmons showed that he wasn't that guy. But Harden just hasn't been the same ever since the 2021 playoffs, and really before that, because when he first hurt his hamstring, that was like the first sign that things were starting to happen, and then it continued to get worse. And now, ever since that time, he just hasn't been that guy. But in the offseason, James Harden kind of became self-aware, and I like what he did, because he decided to decline more money and sacrifice money to help the team so they can go for a championship run next season. But to be honest, as great as this is by James Harden, it really depends on his performance on the court. Because right now, he is the major X factor for the Philadelphia 76ers going into next season. As we already know what we're going to get from Joel Embiid, we know what you're going to get from Tyrese Maxey. But James Harden is kind of a question mark, and it's crazy to say that, because when you look at the legacy of James Harden, you know who he is. But right now, at this point in his career, I don't know what he is. I don't know if he's going to be that consistent an efficient scoring option for this team, whether that's the second option, whether that's the third option. And I know a lot of Philly fans would probably prefer that he be the second option, because first of all, you brought him in to be the second option, not the third. But to be honest, I wouldn't even have a problem with him being the third option, because that would just mean that Tyrese Maxey took another step. But nonetheless, it just comes down to him, because we already know he's a great playmaker and he will command the opponent's attention just off the reputation he has alone as a great scorer. But it really just comes down to him staying healthy, getting his body back in tip-top shape as well, because it seems like ever since the hamstring injury in 2021, it's just been a reoccurring theme for him and a reoccurring injury that just took away a lot of what he had beforehand, and a lot of that explosion off the dribble that he used to have back in Houston, and a lot of the separation that he would get off of his dribble moves that he just can't get right now. And right now, to be honest, I don't expect Harden to ever be that guy that would average 35 points per game and put up constant 40-point games like we saw in Houston. But at least on this team, with guys like Embiid, Maxey, and Harris that can all score, he won't have as much of a burden. But if Harden can't contribute on the scoring end, then you might as well just chalk up the season for the Philadelphia 76ers, because their hopes of winning an NBA title next season very much is in the hands of Harden. And if he can produce at a high level, because if he can't, then you're just not going to see them reach their full potential. And the thing is, time is kind of ticking, especially with Harden. He's already at that point where he's not really old, but in about 2-3 years, you can consider him like an OG in the league now. Like, he'll be one of those guys 36, 35 years old, not the same player at all. So time is ticking, and Embiid is in the middle of his prime. Who knows what happens 2 or 3 years from now, but we're looking at next season. And if next season James Harden can't give you, you know, 23, 10, and 8 on efficient numbers, because he gives you that, you know, the numbers wise, except for the shooting percentages. Like if you look at just pure point per game numbers or rebound per game numbers, he gives you everything. He gives you the 22 points per game and the rebounds and the assist. But this past season was horrible. I mean, when you're shooting 41, 40% from the field, low 30s from three, that's not him. And he's going to need to get back to shooting at least league average if he wants this team to be in the NBA Finals next season or even contending for an NBA Finals appearance going into next season. Anyways, that's going to do it. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Also, follow me on Twitter and Instagram. Link will be down in the description below. This has been a checkup where we talk hoops and hoops only. And I'll see y'all in the next video. Peace.